Today we're talking about India, the geopolitical equivalent of your successful high school friend. You're definitely aware they exist and are pretty powerful, but you only think of them when, oh yeah, how are they doing? I should really check up on them. And then you forget again. The question we're discussing today is, essentially, who cares about India? And not in the derogatory sense, but the literal one. Because they just signed a massive deal that will break all sorts of US sanctions. And, well, we're just not sure if anyone cares enough to reach out, or even just send them a LinkedIn message. India signed a deal with Russia to acquire the S-400 air defense missile system, despite the possibility that such a move could trigger US sanctions. Now, this makes a lot of sense for India, because if you think our neighbors Canada and Mexico hate us, try having China and Pakistan for neighbors. Now, I'm not going to go into too much details on the problem because I want to keep this video under 2 hours. But for the sake of this episode, we'll just say their relationship status is it's complicated. And a sophisticated surface-to-air missile defense system equal to the one China owns isn't out of the question. The problem comes in when...
Well, the United States has finally reacted to India's deal with Russia for the procurement of the 5S-400 missile systems. The US State Department spokesperson has told Vyond that the United States continues to urge all of its allies to forego transactions with Russia that could invite sanctions. Referring to the Trump administration's recent sanctions on China, the State Department has said that sanction waivers are not country-specific.
The specific sanctions that are in question here are from the Countering American Adversaries Through Sanctions Act, which targets Russia, Iran, and North Korea. This act specifically prohibits any country from signing defense deals with these nations, something that definitely covers buying surface-to-air missile defense systems. But the question remains, do we care? Now this might surprise you knowing how decisive Donald Trump usually is. But while US President Donald Trump has the power to provide waivers to some countries, of which India is hoping to secure one, recent statements from some Trump administration officials have sent mixed messages. Great, because in dealing with international arms treaties, that's the perfect time to be vague. So let's look at this from a few different perspectives. First, India, because they're the first movers. Now they have a few reasons to buy Russian. First,
Russia agreed to jointly build 10 nuclear plants in India. Defense was also high up on the agenda. A defense pact was signed with the two sides agreeing to joint production of military helicopters and fighter jets.
That was 3 years ago, and for those of you listening to the podcast version of this, that was about a Russia-India defense deal. India has been buying from Russia for a long time. Rajiv Nayan, a defense expert at the Institute for Defense Studies and Analysis think tank, wow, he sounds relevant, said India already operates defense systems manufactured by Russia, and it would make sense to continue with the systems we are familiar with. And I don't blame them. I mean, I already can't get my iPhone to sync with my Windows computer. If you had 20 missiles heading directly towards me, well, I feel sorry for whoever is taking my call at the Genius Bar. Remember, this act was put into place in 2017, so it's not the craziest thing in the world to imagine that some countries wouldn't suddenly make an about-face because America told them to. The other reason this order is a little more alarming, some are saying it's
India telling the world that it is going to hedge its bets between the US and Russia. It sees the US as a declining power, China as a rising nation. And in this very confused, multipolar world today, the Prime Minister Modi's government is sending the message that it wants to deal with all sides.
Well, as an American, that is not a great thing to hear. Although, it's not as radical as that sounds, of course. But, and this might surprise you, India is definitely not happy with the Donald right now. I recently covered the new NAFTA agreement, and while most people who attended Trump's announcement heard about the agreement, our president has a tendency to ramble, and India heard something different.
India, which is the tariff king, they called us and they say, we want to start negotiations immediately. When Bob Lighthizer said, what happened? You would never do this. They said, no, we want to keep your president happy. Isn't that nice?
You're not going to believe this, but, well, India's media jumped all over this.
India wants a trade deal with the US to keep me happy. Those were the words from Donald Trump. The US president has criticized India yet again for levying high tariffs on products.
All right, first, it's never a good sign when a foreign country's news outlet has literally created an infographic for your country's trade war. Is that a reoccurring segment? Anyways, yeah, most of their coverage was not English, except for a few key words.
Tech se naraz Trump ne Bharat ko tariff king ta keh diya.
Alright, I definitely got the word Trump and tariff king. There was a lot of that, because apparently people aren't happy when the US president says that your leader wants to negotiate a bilateral trade agreement to make America happy. This is no isolated incident either, because no way, the US got into a trade war with India. Poor India, and I mean that metaphorically and literally. The trade war didn't even make it to the Financial Times when I searched India trade war using relevant results. It's all China. I swear, when I started writing this episode, I thought I was going to be taking a break from covering this trade war, but I guess not. So let's get you caught up on what has been a leading story in India. Trump struck the first blow with his steel and aluminum tariffs, and then India tried hard to get an exemption, but failed. Then in response, India began imposing what it deemed proportionate payback worth $240 million on 29 American export items, including almonds, chickpeas, and chocolates. Although that means more chocolate for us, so I'm not terribly mad about that last part. Now, this was all predicted by one person.
India is unlikely to be granted an exemption from the higher tariffs on imports of steel and aluminium imposed by the United States. A top Trump official has said that India could well be in a position to retaliate. But the U.S. Trade Representative Robert Lighthizer has told lawmakers during a congressional hearing that India's system is not open and has a lot of vulnerabilities that it can actually exploit in hitting back at the United States.
Then this dispute just got crazy, with Lighthizer threatening to revoke India's non-reciprocal trade benefits, in which the World Trade Organization allows developing countries to use certain subsidies on exports. Looking it up on the WTO website, the latest is that a panel was formed on July 23rd, 2 months ago. Man, they move slowly over there. Still, hey Lighthizer, have fun arguing that India is no longer a developing country. All of that to say that the US is India's single largest trading partner, with the two-way flow totaling more than $100 billion a year. While India, with all of these trade wars, might not want to keep it that way. Pratyush Rao, Associate Director for India and South Asia at Control Risks Consultancy, described it as a catch-22 situation for Delhi, with it having to walk the diplomatic tightrope between a trusted but waning ally, Russia, and a growing yet temperamental partner, the US. So now let's go to the other side of the coin. Recently,
the US has hit the Chinese military with sanctions over its purchase of missile systems and fighter jets from Russia. The State Department said the move was authorized by the Countering America's Adversaries Through Sanctions Act.
That was reported 2 weeks ago and covers literally the exact same situation India's in. China bought the same missile system from Russia and was sanctioned by the same act India's currently trying to get exempt from. Although, I'm not sure China was exactly freaking out over the sanctions. You're telling me America isn't buying certain things from us anymore? Is this because of the first set of tariffs, the second set of tariffs, the aluminum and steel tariffs? Oh no, it's the sanctions? Well, just add it to the pile. So again, do we exempt India for doing exactly the same thing China did? The answer might lie with Turkey?
Russia will start delivering the S-400 missile defense system to Turkey in 2019.
What is up with this S-400 defense system? It's like keeping up with the Joneses Asia edition. Oh, did you see? China got the new defense system. Well, it's the must-have item for the 2019 collection. NATO ally Turkey is also in the process of acquiring the same system, and many believe that's a red line the US doesn't want Turkey to cross. So what do you do? Unambiguously punish anyone who does business with Russia? Besides the president. On the other hand, you have India, who makes very few of its own weapons and is the world's biggest defense buyer. And if there's one thing that the US is good at exporting, it's defense. Regarding India, the United States is one of its top arms suppliers, closing $15 billion worth of deals in the last decade alone. And that's a lot of money to leave on the table, considering a lasting defense relationship with India would be very lucrative for us. So that's what's going on in the stable half of South Asia right now. No sanctions have been announced yet, but this is some hot off the press news. Until next time, that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan comedy news, remember to subscribe by clicking on the floating logo to the right of my head. Or do it the old-fashioned way by clicking the subscribe button below. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and remember to give me a thumbs up. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.